Green on. Good morning, chili dogs. What you focus on grows. Feed them horses. Got three more pots coming at you guys, so we're gonna get right into that here. Camera B. Ready against that other hand, and then slowly bring this up. It seems like I have a ton of air bubbles in this clay, so I'm gonna bring this down right away. Curl this down into that other hand and get ready to project that back up. There we go. Water. Again, my hand's right underneath, slowly projecting it up into that other hand. And do you see how I have a thin spot there? Right here is getting a little bit wonky, so I have a strong feeling that it's going to want to tear there if I go too crazy with it, right? So again, we're going to push this back down. A little bit more water. Make sure my hand is on this left third here, right? Keeping that down. I'm using my elbow, right? Do you see how my wrist isn't bending back and I'm not using the palm of my hand? I'm using the back of my hand right where my wrist is connected there, right? And so if you hold it there long enough, you'll see where's all that clay gathering, right? It's gathering right in that middle part of your hand because you have all the pressure right here, right? And so then I'm slowly bringing this down. And you see how my thumb is out almost across that middle point here? I'm slowly bringing my fist right back, getting all that off-center clay out to that edge, and that's how I get it centered, right? Call our friend of the stream, Yo Llama! What's up, guys? It's me, Llama, here. We're gonna get ready for a nice little llama pole. You know what we love? We love volcanoes. I'll see you guys down there in a second. Camera B. And so I'm slowly going to be pulling my hand, the llama hand is coming backwards, as my left hand is slowly going to be pushing forward, right? And it's that back and the, almost like it's that oncoming and ongoing traffic, that back and forth there, that's going to cause that rim to go inward, right? Because it's coming across, it's cutting across that circle, right? And that's how it's going to keep on center. Do I need extra care with all the clay on my hands? No. My hands used to crack really bad, right? And what do I mean like that? Not like the bones were cracking, but like the skin would like tear when I bent my fingers, right? And then all of a sudden it just stopped doing that. So I think my body was finally like, all right, this guy's not giving up. Like, let's just like add more moisturizer there. Natural moisturizer, please. Thank you. All right. And so that was the first pull. The first couple pulls, they're really all about getting that thickness equalized within this clay here, right? All right. Making sure we don't go too narrow on this top. I feel like we already are a little bit narrow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. That's slowly twisting up. And we're going to hold that top rim so it twists up extra on this top here. Hold that down just a little bit, right? Have my hands on this interior. Get ready to slowly twist this out, making sure. Slow down when it's at its limit. Pause. Come out, kiss that rim. There we go. You notice that these ones today will probably be a lot smaller. They're about a lot less clay than what they were the past couple days, but I'm almost out of clay here, so I gotta go run to the clay place here pretty soon. I'm gonna push this, pull this up. Whew. All right, camera C. All right, I'll give you guys a pottery edit. Goated one. Goated one. Camera B. Push down a little bit. There we go. David says, hey, hey. Somebody says, yeah, Beyblades? Sweet. So some people know about the Beyblades. A problem over here. Slowly walk this up. And we're going to see there's a little wobble here. We're going to tilt that over, and our left hand, our right hand's going to go right down to where that wobble is, and slowly meet that, and then slowly bring that up to our other hand, and there we go. And that's how we get that back on center there. Get that center. We need some more water. And get down, and look at where my hand's at. Always on that third over here, not through the middle. Always on that third. Look at my wrist. My wrist isn't bent. It's not, no tensions right there. It's all right on that back of my wrist there. Do you have other source of income other than content? I don't make any money from the content or from my pots. I just teach classes. That's how I make money. What am I making? I'm making trees. So again, you can see my left hand is pushing forward, right? That's really the goal here, right? And so it's pushing forward on that third. My right hand is coming back towards myself, slowly bringing all that off-centered clay out to the edge. That's coming around, hitting this hand, which is right into my hip bone, using my body weight. Always use your body weight, right? I don't know what's happening, to be honest. I just find this stream and I can't stop watching. Thank you. Just pass this on live on shorts. What are you doing? What bro doing? I'm making trees. So music's called Bossa Nova. Oh, and I got some of my hair. That's the perks of having long hair nowadays. All right, you guys ready? We got our friend of the stream coming in, saying hello. Welcome. Llama. What's up, guys? It's me, Llama here. We got a couple of things we gotta do, but first off, I'm thinking we're missing a volcano on the screen right now. It's my favorite thing. It's the thing you're about to see. Let's get into it. Camera B. Slowly take your llama. Your llama's gonna bite on this top rim while your left hand's slowly pushing forward. And it's that those hands coming across center, which is bringing that rim inwards, right? Do you call this art or craftsmanship? The end result is something practical. So what do you think? Another question, does room temperature, humidity have an impact on what I do? Okay, so the first thing, do I call this art or craftsmanship? It's neither. This is, like, what would you call if you were, say you were trying to make a change in your life. Say you were really overweight and you wanted to make that change to like lose a bunch of weight, right? And so you start running every day. Would you call yourself a runner? I don't know if I would say that, right? Because you're trying to fix something that you thought you needed to fix, right? And so I feel like that's more of what my work's about. It's trying to fix something that I felt like I was lacking before. push in ever so slightly. Again, find this little bump. And if you see a little wobble, don't freak out. Maintain that bump and just take it to the top. We might be going a little bit too thin, but that's okay. There we go. We're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, And so sometimes, we'll see how well this works here. Sometimes we want to do a manual twist, but other times we can just allow this top to slowly twist this up for us. And then slowly pushing this out. Curl our fingers in, slow down that wheel. Get ready to stop. There we go. Kiss that rim there. The least amount of time I spend touching them, the better they usually turn out, right? So there's one. So if I'm looking at this one, I'm probably going to take the second one and bring some more time in this right here, right underneath. So there we go. As you can see, I'll slowly bring this in, 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 bring this in. Right? And so kind of playing with that gesture to give it some personality. Right? Alrighty. Oh, somebody asked the best question. How often do I build these pots? Thank you for asking that question. I feel like a lot of times, why am I thanking you, first of all? Because I feel like most people, they ask, how many can you make in a day, right? What's the biggest pot you've made? Like, all these high intensity in a short amount of time, right? Where I found true intensity is consistency, right? I'll always say that. And so, how often I build these pots? I build them every single day, right? And I've done that almost for a whole entire year now. I record every single day, and I post every single day, right? And so, Why am I saying that? It's because I feel like so many people fixate on this small intensity. I was even one of those people. I would be like, I'm going to make 280 cups in a day, all trimmed, you know? And that's what I would do. I would just go do it, right? And then after, I'd sit there and I'd be like, oh, that was great, you know? And then I realized that wasn't intensity at all. That was just me, like, doing it, right? Where real intensity is when you fight against that demon in the brain, right? When all of a sudden the holidays come around, it's Christmas and you're all alone, and then instead of, you know, going out somewhere, you go back into the dungeon and you get it done, right? A little bit of water right there. Push this up. There we go. All right, a little bit of water. Again, push this in and up. A little bit of water right on this bottom edge here. We probably got one more pull, so we're gonna go over to camera A. And you're gonna see a wobble, but the key is look below my hands, right? Do you see how below my hands it's all nice and centered? That's what you're focusing on, okay? And whenever you get to the top, you're gonna get ready. Right, and you're gonna see a little wobble. Don't freak out. Right hand's gonna go wherever that wobble is and slowly lead that up to that top hand. You see that wobble going back? Go right back down. Chill out, slowly lead that back up to that top hand. Right? Look how that works, right? That's how you're keeping on center. Sometimes I'm starting to feel that it's wanting to rip and tear here. So I'm gonna chill out, add some more water. I'm gonna start going straight down instead of on an angle, making sure wherever I feel that bump, I'm slowly just gonna try to overpower that, use my fingers to claw down. Sometimes if the clay is too hard, it's gonna rip off the whole entire thing. But it seems like we're good. We're going to swap over to camera C. Slowly pushing my fist down, down, down. And there we go, right? And that's how we get it centered, right? Watch the speed. So if I have my foot off the wheel, right? Foot's over there. Do you see the speed, right? And so watch it in the middle. The middle is a dead zone. It doesn't move. When it's right here, moves a little bit, right? When it's out to the edge, do you see how it looks like it's moving faster? Because it's traveling more distance, right? And so the same thing is if you have your two thumbs are fighting for that middle, it's gonna kick it all the way, or one of the thumbs is gonna kick the other thumb into that circular motion, right? That woo. And so what you wanna make sure you do is that you keep both fingers down, and that one's off to the side. You see how this one's over here a little bit? And so when I'm pushing this one down, I'm keeping that one in the middle centered, so I don't throw it off center, and so I don't open it weird, you know? Somebody said, I have a question. Have you failed? Oh, I fail all the time. That's part of it. I feel like if you're not failing, then you're not doing something that's challenging enough, really. All right down to the bottom one more time. Slowly taking your finger, pushing this in. Slowly project your finger on the inside upwards. And there you go. You have this little bump. And it's a quest that the clay gives you, right? And whenever you see it starting to wobble a little bit more, just slow down a little bit. Allow that clay to realign itself to be in that center. And then just like a slug trying to find his next meal, you're slowly just walking this up, right? Right to that top edge there. And there we go. Okay. Privilegiados têm ouvido igual ao seu. Eu possuo apenas o que Deus me deu. Se você insiste em classificar. So you're gonna watch this one twist up. So here we are. Our hands on this inside here, slowly popping this out. And so watch that twist up. We're gonna go out as far as we can. Slow down the wheel. There we go. And then kiss that round. And so this is one that's a little bit more uniform than the other ones, but some of that clay. There we go. And that's number three of the day. So I'm gonna swap over to another pottery edit, and then I'm gonna set this up, and then I'll see you guys in a second for the pottery review. All right. Goated one. Another pottery review for you guys. We'll start off with this one. I feel like this one might be the winner of the day. There's something about the uniformity of this one that I actually felt like did something cool today. I felt like the process of this one was actually the most fun, right? It was a little bit shorter. When the clay's thicker, it's a little bit more sturdy, and it's a lot easier to get these ones, right? I did a little skirt on the bottom there, but it's not too, I didn't curl it or make petals out of it, I just kind of let it be. I think that the contrast from that base up into that middle part, out to that top edge there, I think it actually looks pretty nice. But we'll go over to this one right here. This one I feel like I'm playing a lot with the gesture of the pot, right? When I'm looking at the way that the arms are kind of hanging out, right? I feel like it starts branching its way away from kind of the uniformity, the very pottery aesthetic, and starting to bridge more perhaps into sculpture, right? And then we got the one on the top here. This is the one that kind of was a little bit, it was the most narrow of the day, and it felt like it's about to collapse. But I think there's something that happens when that petals or the tendrils there, they start to become a little bit more like grass on the bottom of the tree, really kind of giving it this floral nature or its natural look to it, right? Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. All the best and strong mentality. Dang it. All the best and strong mentality. Computer. All right. I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace out. Tomorrow is a year of posting every day, y'all. So I'm going to look back and I'm going to see the first video I post on the channel, which will be kind of fun.